With their live concerts, TV appearances, and recording sessions, the New Kids rarely have a moment to themselves. But they still find time to visit with the people who've helped make them so successful, their fans.
We're ready. We're going to tell school children all across America what school is all about.
Ladies, if I went to Bernard Junior High School with all these beautiful girls out here, I would want to be in school every single day. A lot of people say, oh, you guys are lucky, you're famous and everything. But there's a lot to do in life. You just have to go out and do it. You might say, well, my career or my life after school is far away. I'm only in the 8th or 9th grade. But remember, it's just around the corner. It's sneaking up on you. If you think the first 8 years of your school went by fast, wait till you see the last 4. Stay in school, start thinking about your career and your life now. Say no to drugs, peace, and eat your vegetables. We love you.
Why do you guys like visiting the schools so much?
It's kind of a way of returning the favor to our fans. I mean, they're helping us, so we're helping them at the same time. You know, if their mothers or teachers and stuff say, oh, say, you know, don't do drugs, kids are going to say, why don't they want me to do drugs? Let me try them and find out what the big deal is. You know, so if other kids who people look up to are saying it, maybe they'll respect that and then not try it.
Part of the whole idea about being a public eye makes you a hero to a lot of people. You know, who keeps you in line? Because this stuff must get to your head at some time.
I think basically, you know, we're all still the same regular 5 guys we were when we were 6 or 7 years old running around in kindergarten. But, you know, it's different. It's a lot hectic-er schedule.
That's a word.
A busier schedule.
More hectic.
You know, but we're the same.
If you weren't playing music with the New Kids, would you be playing music somewhere else?
Yeah, once the New Kids, you know, go out and do their own thing, I would probably go into TV, movies or something like that. And still sing.
Yeah.
I like to sing.
I'll be now, baby.
Do you miss the other stuff, though? The stuff about just being a kid, you know, going to high school and going to the prom and,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's tough sometimes.
Playing on a football team.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't have made the football team. But, yeah, it's just, it's a lot more carefree, you know?
Yeah.
And, I mean, when you're out on the road, you just have a lot more to think about. But, you know, it's cool that I'm doing it at a younger age, because if something, you know, if it ended tomorrow, I would still have my whole life ahead of me, you know what I mean, so.
Do you miss doing the acting stuff? Do you miss the theater? Or...
Yeah, but you know, a stage is a stage, and what we do out on the stage is just performing.
Yeah.
And I love to entertain.
When you were growing up, did you have any heroes?
When I was in elementary school, I used to look up to Martin Luther King. I just remember every year, you know, when his birthday came around or something, there would always be a big thing in our school. I always remember that and seeing the films, him saying his speeches.
But that's real rare that even that, you know, that you would say Martin Luther King, because he's a hero to so many black Americans. Are you conscious of the whole race problem in America?
Well, yeah, but I guess that's just because when I was going to school, that's when busing started.
Right.
And I was bused to an all-black area, me along with Donnie, Jordan, and John, and we were the minorities, you know? So even when at that point and now, I don't look at anyone like, that's my black friend, that's my Puerto Rican friend. They're just my friend. And their skin's just a different color.
Yeah.
Big deal. It matters what's inside here.
Yeah.
It, you know, it doesn't don't judge the book by its cover.
Before you start with New Kids, what did you know? Like, what did you think you were going to do?
Nothing.
Yeah.
I don't know. I was always good in school, so, you know, I would have went to college. I was going to college.
Oh, you did?
At BU. I have a four-year scholarship there.
Boston University Terrier.
Yeah. I went there for a little bit, but then, you know, I left for the group.
Yeah.
But I still have my scholarship, so I can go back when I want to.
Would you
want to
go back sometime?
Depending on what happens, you know, I think I want to go back. Yeah.
You miss out, like, on the whole rah-rah college atmosphere?
I don't really miss it. I'd rather be with these guys than at any college party.
Biscuit, you've been with the New Kids how long now?
Over a year.
And do you enjoy being with the New Kids? I mean,
love
what's it.
It
like?
I love it. It's wild. It's exciting.
Is it?
It's a little crazy at times.
I never know what I'm doing until the day it happens.
But it's a family, man. We love each other.
Jordan, you got shampoo?
You're real lucky because you have a brother on the tour.
Yeah, we started singing when we were 6 years old. And every summer since we were 6 years old, we'd go to a summer camp that was held by... it's a company in England that's the Royal School of Church Music.
Oh, yeah?
And, like, we used to sing in Latin. You know, we didn't even sing in English. When we were 6 years old, we couldn't even read English.
Right.
And here we are singing in another language. And we just had, you know, a lot of training. I mean, they'd wake you up at 6 o'clock in the morning. You'd be at rehearsal at 7. And it was just rehearsal all day, learning everything new.
When you look back at what made you want to be part of this group, is part of it because you have a desire to be a performer?
Yeah, and just the thrill of it all, you know. When I first heard about it, Jordan came home and he was telling me everything that our producer told him. And our producer told Jordan, you know, I want you guys to be as big as the Beatles. And it was funny because Jordan always wanted a Honda scooter.
Yeah.
And, you know, he couldn't afford it at the time. And our producer kept telling him, you know, if you stick with me, you'll have a Honda scooter for every day of the year.
Yeah.
He told him that. And he just told him a lot of, you know, real positive things. And Jordan came home and he told me, and I said, well, you ain't leaving me behind.
And I know tomorrow will be the same. Yeah. It seems like a dream to me. That won't ever change. Every day, love me,
ever since, like, kindergarten, me and John always been the two that were always seen together, you know. And sometimes I feel lonely and down and homesick, and I just look at John and I, you know, feel better.
Our generation, a lot of us are the first generation that can't expect to do better than our parents. You know, our parents made a great living, and they made it better than their parents. But you're doing something, you know, where you're beyond, I'm sure, even your mom's wildest dreams for you. You know?
Yeah, I look at it as I got lucky, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just God's will, you know?
If you weren't doing it, would you still be singing somewhere else? Would you be back in the church choir? Would you be?
It's really hard to say where I would be, because before I joined the group, I really didn't look ahead, and that's something that the kids in the world, you know, have to do. They gotta prepare for the future, because they are the future.
Yeah.
And I'm real lucky that, you know, the group really got successful.
It's amazing in just like the last year what's happened.
Yeah.
I mean, if you just take a breath, Jordan, you know, and you think to yourself, whoa, we're on a skyrocket. It's 4th of July and Christmas and everything all at once.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it seems like every day is Christmas. We get flowers and gifts and everything, every day. It's unbelievable. But, you know, I'll never be able to see it as, say, you would see it, you know, because I'm on the inside. I don't really, I'm not in a classroom hearing girls saying, oh, Donnie's so fine, and if you look at his picture, I'll beat you up, boy. You know? People from the outside, you know, all the fans and stuff, they look at us like we're magical, but we're just ordinary guys.
In real life, Kids on the Block.